This morning I'm talking with clinical psychologist Dr. Steven Ragusea about mentally ill in prison. Now, according to a recent report by Human Rights Watch, there are three times as many men and women with mental illness in prisons as there are in mental health facilities. Dr. Ragusea, how did prisons become our new mental health facilities?
Well, it's really a long and sad story. First of all, you have to remember that at one point we had a very complex network of state mental hospitals all over the United States. And they were there to take care of people who needed to be hospitalized because they were severely mentally ill. Mm-hmm. And that was a great improvement over Bedlam, for example, in London in the 1800s. But then what happened was, during the John Kennedy administration, what John Kennedy did was he worked to establish a system of community mental health centers that were placed all throughout the United States in essentially every county seat in the United States, and other places as well had a community mental health center. And Kennedy focused on that because he had a sister who was severely mentally ill. And so they built these mental health facilities, or community mental health, mental retardation facilities, or sometimes called MHMRs, all over the United States. And the notion behind that was that the mentally ill, when it was a severe case, could be taken care of better in their home communities using the MHMR system, rather than putting them far away from their families in these large state hospitals. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now, that was the theory behind it. And it worked really well as long as Kennedy was president, and then through Lyndon Johnson's presidency. But then what happened was that Richard Nixon came in. And Richard Nixon began to close the community mental health centers, not by closing them, he simply withdrew funds from them. Mm-hmm. So what he did was starve them to death. And the community mental health centers gradually closed, and all the state hospitals were gradually closed. Mm-hmm. So that left very little in the way of ways to treat the mentally ill. Okay. Mm-hmm. At the same time, Richard Nixon and Spiro Agnew, who you remember, Spiro Agnew went to jail himself, his vice president, and Nixon, of course, was impeached and then resigned from the presidency. Both of them decided that they were going to get tough on crime, and that was their battle cry for years. So what they did was they fought to increase minimum sentences for prisoners, they fought to build more prisons, and at the same time, while all that was going on, they were closing the state mental hospitals and closing the MHMRs, so that the mental health centers couldn't take care of the patients anymore. Now, when you've got somebody who's severely mentally ill and they act in ways that are grossly inappropriate, what are you going to do with them?
Absolutely.
And so they put them in jail. Mm-hmm. And that was part of the way that the prison population increased. There's a graph that I think you'll be able to put on the air for people so that they can look at this. And what happened was that from that point in time, the U.S. prison population just began to skyrocket. And it grew and grew and grew and has continued to grow all these years. So that now we can proudly say, we are number one in terms of prison population in the world. Mm-hmm. We incarcerate a higher percentage of our population in jails and prisons than any other nation on the face of the earth. Think about that. So right
it's hard
now,
to even fathom that.
It is. Mm-hmm. And people don't understand it. Mm-hmm. But we put approximately 1% of our population behind bars. That's a lot of people. That's as many people, for example, if what we've got is 340 million people in the United States right now, mm-hmm. that's about 3.4 million people. Now think of a city of 3.4 million.
Mm-hmm. That's okay? Too large of a number.
That's half the size of New York City. Mm-hmm. Okay, and that's how many people we've got in jails in this country. Mm-hmm. Now, that ain't cheap, by the way.
I was just going to say, that's costing us money because it's our taxes that are paying for that, correct?
That's correct. In fact, it costs about $25,000 to $35,000 per prisoner per year just to keep them in jail. That doesn't include building the jail.
Mm-mm.
That includes just keeping them in the jail you've already built. Now multiply that times 3.5 million people, and you're talking about a whole lot of money.
Way too much money that we are spending right now. Well, we're going to take a quick break right now, but pick back up this discussion when we return from these messages. So please don't go away.